Waterloo, Ontario, University Ave. It's a wild neighborhood, but hey, it's home.
Why are you talking like that?
Just filming a vlog, trying to remember my time as a Hacksmith intern. Whoa, it's Hacksmith Industries. I've been watching these videos for years.
Oh my goodness, it's the Smithmobile. Okay, Caleb, this is the Hacksmith Industries Electronics Lab.
This awesome.
You're going to be spending a lot of your time.
Wow.
And your desk is right over here. Got everything you need, got your laptop, got some safety glasses, you got your lab coat. Just get suited up and we've got a project to start on.
Okay, I will. Thank you, Bogdan, sir.
All right. It's a Smith shirt. A note from Mr. Smith himself. Welcome to the team. I can't wait to see what kind of projects I'm going to be working on. Now, Mr. Smith did say something about augmenting human senses.
When people think of Spider-Man, the first thing that comes to mind is web-slinging, climbing walls. But equally as important is that spider sense. Wait, do spiders even have a spider sense? It must be based on something. They can sense vibrations. So what? So can I. Anyway, in the comics, Spider-Man's able to sense impending danger, dodging punches, and even bullets. However, we humans just don't stack up. That is, until today. You see, sometime last year, Mr. Smith saw a project by a guy who goes by Brain Devices. He used an ultrasonic sensor and a vibration motor to alert the wearer of approaching danger. Using advanced Hacksmith Industries technology, I'm going to miniaturize this system. And I might even have spider senses in three dimensions. How cool would that be? But first, I'm thirsty. Hacksmith.store. Curse you, gravity! We picked up this awesome animatronic helmet. Its eyes adjust, so it gives you that classic Spidey scowl. Our plan is to outfit this mask with multiple circuit boards that will be able to detect motion and then output a spider sense tingle for the wearer. But it's not good enough to have the whole helmet vibrate. The spidey sense not only alerted Parker to danger, it also let him know where the danger was approaching from. Well, the entire helmet won't actually vibrate. The sensor will trigger a buzz in the location of the sensor that picked up the movement. So, for example, if someone dropped a piano on my head from up above, the sensor on the top of my head would trigger the buzzer in the same spot, alerting me to the danger from above. Make sense? Now, we need to make some decisions on components. First, we have the distance sensor. You may have heard of radar. Radar sends out radio waves, then listens for it to bounce off objects. It's then able to calculate where that object is. This is a LiDAR, basically the same concept as radar, except instead of sending out radio waves, it sends out light. And this little guy can detect up to 4 meters of distance with 1 millimeter accuracy. Now, a sensor only outputs information. We need a microcontroller to both interpret and use that information. We've chosen the ATtiny 85. It's nice and small, and it's powerful enough to understand I2C, the communication protocol used by the LiDAR. So, to summarize, the LiDAR is going to measure the distance from the sensor to the object. Then the LiDAR will communicate that information to the microcontroller. The microcontroller will process that and then send it to an appropriate output. And in our case, that output is a tingle. Now, I just need to find something that'll tingle. I've got a few ideas. There are some requirements. It has to be small, has to be wearable, and has to be safe. Now, this is a shock collar, and this is a taser. Taser doesn't sound too safe. Anyways, what were those instructions that Mr. Smith gave me?
Don't do anything I would do, and definitely don't do anything I wouldn't do. There's a little gray area, and that's where you operate.
Hopefully this falls into that category. Well, here goes nothing. Okay, not safe. Taser?
okay?
Doing pretty good.
I was thinking, like, what about using one of those things that makes the cell phone vibrate?
That would be a better idea. Okay, yeah, let's do that.
Today was crazy, man. Probably shouldn't have paced myself, but I wanted to show that I was committed to the project, you know, wanting to contribute. And contributed by learning you shouldn't use a taser. We're going to be using a vibration motor. So simple. Why didn't I think of that? Well, I'm going to have to make a prototype tomorrow. It's going to be good. And I hope Mr. Smith is impressed.
Picking out all the right components to build a custom PC can be a daunting task. Is my motherboard compatible with this RAM? And wait, what about this graphics card? Things get complicated quick, so why not let the experts do it for you? Microcenter offers an online custom PC builder tool to spec out the best PC for your needs that fits your budget. Not only that, the tool also ensures compatibility between the selected components. If you want to do the research yourself, you can use the brand new online Microcenter community. It's a great place to discuss tech with other enthusiasts. Finally, if building just isn't your thing, you can have one of the pros at Microcenter build it for you. Use my link in the description below to receive a coupon for a free pair of Bluetooth headphones.
Before I design and order the PCBs, I'm going to build a functional prototype to make sure that all of these components work together as expected. I wrote a program for the ATtiny that will read distances from the LiDAR and make the vibration motor pulse differently depending on how far away an object is. As you can see, the ATtiny doesn't have a USB port. So how am I going to get the program on there if I can't connect it to my computer? Well, the Arduino Uno does have a USB port, and I can connect my Tiny to the Uno, and then I'll be able to flash the chip. Now, it's called flashing because the process wipes all the previous memory off of the ATtiny and then uploads a new program. And voila, it's now uploading, as you can see from all this text moving by. I'm gonna make my prototype on this breadboard because it allows me to easily connect all of our components. Our microcontroller, LiDAR, and vibration motor. Everything's plugged in and it looks like it's working well. I can't think of a better way to demonstrate than some action figure theater.
Just your friendly neighborhood Spider-Man, keeping an eye out on the neighborhood. Hopefully no bad guys start approaching me from behind.
Ha ha ha, it's Dr. Octopus. I'm gonna come and say hi to Spider-Man. Hopefully his spider senses aren't tingling faster as I approach him linearly from behind.
Dun 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 dun!
I've been found. I will retreat.
As you can see, the I2C bus between the LiDAR and microcontroller is working just as expected. I2C is super cool. Without it, this project would not work at all. It's a multi-master, multi-slave, packet switch, single-ended...
What?
I2C stands for Inter-Integrated Circuit Protocol. It's like a language that is used to communicate between different components, like our LiDAR and ATtiny. The advantage of using I2C is that many components can be connected and all communicate between each other. Each device sends and receives signals over just two wires. For our project, the LiDAR breaks down the distance measurement into a signal that is sent over the two wires. The microcontroller is connected to the same two wires. This allows it to receive the signal from the LiDAR. The microcontroller then looks up the signal in a library to see what it means. There. You happy with that explanation, Mr. Camera Bossman, sir? Can I get on with the PCB design? This is going to be the sensor board. It will contain the ATtiny, the LiDAR, the vibration motor. We're going to order a bunch of these so that we can put them all around the helmet and get the Spidey Sense working from all angles. Sketching this out really helps me plan what I'm going to do when I hop into Altium Designer. All the connections from this prototype need to be represented as lines on this schematic. If you want to see the full diagram in all of its digital glory, check it out on maker.io using the link in the description below. With all of our components mapped out, our next step is to hop into Altium Designer and lay out the board. I've put all the components as close together as possible to keep this board very small. If you would like to see the layout of our board, you can check it out using Altium Viewer.
Another day in the can. Gotta say that video team, sort of annoying. Josh just kept on interrupting me and asking me to take it slower. I mean, how do you make it onto the Hacksmith team without having a solid base of programming fundamentals like I2C and flashing? Oh well, I had to bring it down to like 5-year-old level and bust out some toys to explain it to him. But tomorrow, it's going to be a good day. I'm going to be designing the power board, and I got a special idea in mind for that. And I'm also going to get to build a bunch of the boards, which is going to be pretty hype.
All these boards need to get sewn into the Spider-Man mask. Now, a rigid board would be uncomfortable and would poke out of the side of the mask, but I did some digging and I found out that you can order flexible PCBs. Can you believe it? So, I went and ordered some. Now, all that's left is to take these boards and my bag of LiDARs and AT Tinies and put them all together.
Great power comes great responsibility.
The AT Tiny and the LiDAR are permanently attached to the front. Next step is to solder the vibration motor onto the back of the PCB. All right, we have all of the components attached now. All that's left to do is to plug this into a power supply and make sure that it works. If all goes well, you're gonna see this little light turn on and the motor will start to vibrate. If things don't go well, something might start smoking. With the boards completed and working, I'm ready to integrate them with the Spider-Man mask. Thankfully, Aunt May's a real gem, and she lent me her sewing supplies. I'm going to cut multiple holes in this mask so the LiDAR can peek through. Then, I'll attach them with needle and thread. It's all done, now we're ready for some action. All right, the system's complete. Oh my goodness, guys, come on, we talked about this. I can still see you and I could hear. But we're gonna fix that. So I shall be wearing these earbuds to blast some groovy tunes. And to deal with my ability to see, I'll be wearing a blindfold for the whole test. All right, now that I'm blindfolded and listening to loud music, I can neither see nor hear when and where these balls are coming from. So they're gonna drop them one at a time, and I won't know which one or what time they're coming. Hopefully the spider senses will alert me to both of those details. Got the reflexes of a dead tiger. Oh, come on, guys. I don't even have a sensor on the front. That was just rude. The thing is, the system's working as expected. I mean, I could hear the thing vibrate as the ball was coming. I'm just a human though, so I didn't react fast enough. I was getting closer, so I think let's try a few more times, see if I can get this. That was close. Woo! Air ball. Did your grandma teach you how to throw? Oh my goodness. Probably should have put a sensor on my forehead. All right, that was a bit better. I'm glad I was able to at least block a few, but there is another way we can test this. Let's go for a walk. So as I walk forward, I can feel it lightly pulsing, and I programmed it so it pulses depending on how far away something is. So I know there's a wall over here. Oh, it stopped pulsing. Nope, no, it hasn't. Never mind. Okay. And okay, no pulses on my left, which means I can go left. Now, if I go forward, I'm doing all right. Feeling pulses on both sides. And now I gotta wait until this one stops pulsing, and then I'll know that there's an opening, like right over here. All right, they're both pulsing. There's something nearby, no pulsing. That means I'm in a wide open space, which means I have no direction. Ooh, dark alleyway. I wonder how I'd do in a fight. Though I can't dodge bullets, I can probably dodge some slow motion punches. Owen over here has been training for a month to prepare for this very moment. Bring it on. Well, my spidey senses are telling me that I'm pretty tired. Okay, like we're done the test. You can go. Man, my Hacksmith Industries internship has been incredible. I mean, I get to work on projects like this. This had a LiDAR, flexible PCBs, the whole works. I'm really thankful that Hacksmith has let me work with all sorts of interesting technologies and build really cool projects. Getting to know the team was great. Everyone worked super hard to make these videos happen. I mean, there's lights on me because someone put them there, and that wasn't me, but they are doing a great job. With this project, I'd say in the future, probably would have spent a little more time fine-tuning the programming so that I could react better to things coming at me. But that's the thing with engineering. You have to build something and fine-tune it and keep on making changes, keep on making it better. And yeah, I'm really thankful. It's been a great time here, and I'm gonna miss it. I wanna be your superhero. I am intern no more.